यस फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? हाउ इज़ योर लाइफ गोइंग ऑन? टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द केस स्टडी ऑफ कोरबा. कोरबा स्टैंड्स फॉर द कॉमन ऑब्जेक्ट रिक्वेस्ट ब्रोकर आर्किटेक्चर, इज स्टैंडर्ड डिफाइंड बाय द OMG. OMG स्टैंड्स फॉर ऑब्जेक्ट मैनेजमेंट ग्रुप दैट इनेबल्स सॉफ्टवेयर कंपोनेंट्स रिटन इन मल्टीपल कंप्यूटर लैंग्वेजेस रनिंग ऑन मल्टीपल कंप्यूटर्स टू वर्क टुगेदर. So Corba enables separate pieces of software written in different languages and running on different computers to work with each other like a single application or set of services. More specifically, Corba is a mechanism in software for normalizing the method call semantics between application objects residing either in the same address space or remote address space. Version 1.0 was released in October 1991. Corba uses an IDL. What is IDL? IDL stands for Interface Definition Language to specify the interfaces which objects present to the outer world. Corba then specify a mapping from IDL to a specific implementation languages like C++ or Java. Standard mapping exists for ADA, C, C++, Lisp, Ruby, Smalltalk, Java, COBOL and Python. So there are also non-standard mapping for Perl, Visual Basic, Erlang and TEL implemented by Object Request Brokers, ORBs, written for those languages. Currently, the OMG is working on a new IDL language mapping. More details are available at orbjohn.org. Okay, so the Corba specification dictates there shall be an ORB through which an application would interact with other objects. In practice, the application simply initializes the ORB and accesses an internal object adapter which maintains things like reference counting, object and reference, statiation policy and object lifetime policies, right? The object adapter is used to register instance of the generated code classes. Generated code classes are the result of compiling the user IDL code which translates the high-level interface definition into an OS and language-specified class based for use by the user application. This step is necessary in order to enforce Corba semantics and provide a clean user process for interfacing with the Corba infrastructure. Some IDL mapping are more difficult to use than others. For example, due to the nature of Java, the IDL Java mapping is rather straightforward and makes uses of Corba every simple in a Java application. This is also true of the IDL to Python mapping. The C++ mapping is difficult. The mapping requires the programmer to learn complex and confusing data types that predate the C++ standard template library STL. Currently, work is being done to create a new C++ 0x language binding that will use standard template library heavily. Since the C language is not object oriented, the IDL to C mapping requires a C programmer to manually emulate object oriented features. So a language mapping requires the developer to create IDL code that represents the interfaces to his objects. Typically, a Corba implementation comes with a tool called an IDL compiler, which converts the user's IDL code into some language-specific generated code. A traditional compiler then compiles the generated code to create the linkable object files for the application. This diagram illustrates how the generated code is used within the Corba architecture. Okay, you can see here client main, object reference, generated subcode, object implementation, generated skeleton code, ORB, server main. Okay, and key ORB vendor supplied code, ORB vendor tool generated code, user defined application code. Okay. Next. This figure illustrates the high-level paradigm for remote inter-process communication using CORBA. Issues not addressed here yet accounted for in the CORBA specification, including data typing, exception, network protocols, communication timeouts, etc. For example, normally the server side has the portable object adapter that redirects calls either to the local servants or to the other servers. Also, both servers and client parts often have interceptors that are described below. Issues CORBA does not address, but that all distributed system must address include object lifetimes, redundancy, failover, naming semantics, memory management, dynamic load balancing, separation of model between display, data control, semantics, etc. So in addition to providing users with the language in a platform neutral remote procedure call specification, CORBA defines commonly needed services such as transaction and security, events time, and other domain specific interface models. If we talk about features of CORBA, CORBA supports several features which it claims that no other single technology brings in one package. These benefits include language and OS independence, freedom from technology-linked implementations, strong data typing, high level of tunability, and freedom from the details of distributed data transfers. So, language independence. CORBA at the outset was designed to free engineers from the hangups and limitations of considering their designs based on particular software language. Currently, there are many languages supported by various CORBA providers, the most popular being Java and C++. There are also C only, Smalltalk, Perl, Ada, Ruby, and Python implementations. OS independence. CORBA's design is meant to be OS independent. CORBA is available in Java, OS independent, as well as natively for Linux, Unix, Windows, Sun, Mac, and others. Next, freedom from technologies. One of the main implicit benefits is that CORBA provides a neutral playing field for engineers to be able to normalize the interfaces between various new and legacy systems. When integrating C, C++, Object, Pascal, Java, Fortran, Python, and any other language or OS into a single cohesive system design model, CORBA provides the means to level the field and allow disparate terms to develop systems and unit tests that can later be joined together into a whole system. This does not rule out the need for basic system engineering decisions such as threading, timing, object lifetime, etc. These issues are part of any system regardless of technology. CORBA allows system elements to be normalized into a single cohesive system model. For example, the design of a multiple architecture is made simple using Java servlets in the web server and various CORBA servers containing the business logic and wrapping the database accesses. This allows the implementation of the business logic to change while the interface changes would need to be handled as in any other technology. For example, a database wrapped by a server can have its database scheme changed for the sake of improved disk usage or performance without affecting the external interfaces. At the same time, C++ legacy code can talk to C, Fortran legacy code, and Java database code and can provide data to a web interface. Next, strong data typing. CORBA provides flexible data typing, for example, and any data type. CORBA also enforces tightly coupled data typing, reducing human errors. In a situation where name value pairs are passed around, it is conceivable that a server provides a number where a string was expected. CORBA interface definition language provides the mechanism to ensure that user code conforms to method names, return parameter, method names, return parameter types, and exceptions. Next, high tunability. There are many implementations available that have many options for tuning the threading and connection management features. Not all implementations provide the same feature. This is up to the implementer. Next, freedom from data transfer details. When handling low-level connection and threading, CORBA provides a high level of detail in error condition. This is defined in the CORBA defined standard exception set and the implementation specific extended exception set. Through the exceptions, the application can determine if a call failed for reasons such as small problem, so try again. The server is dead or the reference does not make sense. The general rule is not receiving an exception means that the method call completed successfully. This is a very powerful design feature. CORBA marshals its data. A binary supports compression, IONA, Remedy IT, and Telefonica have worked on an extension to the CORBA standard that delivers compression. This extension is called ZIOP, and this is now a formal OMG standard. So friends, we discussed the introduction to CORBA. Okay, after then we discussed some features. Okay, language independence, OS independence, freedom from technologies, storing data typing, high tunability, freedom from data transfer details, etc. Okay. So I hope you must have got knowledge from this video. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.